I was pretty excited when I found out that we were gonna go up to Yellowstone to do a school project. Being an undergraduate student, we don't get a lot of opportunities to actually go out in the field and practice what we've been learning about, so.
For me, it really was a trip of a lifetime because I've been wanting to go to Yellowstone since I was a little kid, and going there was just fulfilled a dream that I've had for many, many years.
Our experience was more than just exploring the park and taking photos. We really got to look behind the scenes of how the park is run from a sustainable view, which made my experience at least really enlightening. It was very interesting to see how much it takes to run the park, manage the visitors, and make sure those visitors are also satisfied, as well as making sure they are being managed in a sustainable way.
Well, we went out to Yellowstone to assess how the park does in terms of sustainability according to certain criteria, and I was very impressed with what I saw at the park. I was blown away at the scope, with just how large the park is and all of the management that goes into it, from National Park Service and Xanterra and all these groups having to work together to achieve common goals. And I was impressed with how well they were doing with that.
So going in there, having a look at what Xanterra was doing towards sustainability was really interesting. The initiatives towards recycling, and that seemed to be one of their big drives, which I thought was really important because I can immediately see how clean the park was and how dedicated they were towards educating their customers to just understand what kind of impact they have on the environment.
Even though there are some problems with accessibility for people of all abilities and people from all cultures, I think you could tell that they were doing a really good job of trying to make it as accessible as possible. They have beautiful walkways and boardwalks along some of the prettiest geysers in the park, and there were lots of interpretive signage that were in multiple languages, and I think that people from other cultures really appreciate that. It makes it just open to so many more people that can come and see this beautiful place.
For me, it was good to see how they were dedicated towards making sure that the park would be there for the future generations through sustainability.
I was impressed how well the park did behind the scenes, such as director's orders that included civic engagement and public involvement for all decision making inside the park, as well as educational programs offered to the youth during the summer and to all visitors that come to the park.
So one aspect of the park that really blew me away was the Future Generations Yellowstone's gift shop, which is a retail store that blends retail with education. There was just a lot of things that may seem like subtle changes but can make a big difference, and I feel like guests leaving the park have a better overall picture of what their goals are.
I haven't been up to Yellowstone for a long time. It's quite different from when I was a kid. Some of the things I noticed is just how much more education there is available to just to the public, whereas before it was very limited. And I think that they've done a really great job about improving awareness, and I think people respect that idea. And I feel very confident that if they continue with the trends they're setting right now, that they will be a pretty sustainable park in the future. There aren't a lot of beautiful places in this world anymore, and protecting the ones that we still have is very important. So keep going, do a good job, Yellowstone, you're doing great.
Well, pick me up with golden hand. Oh, me say, oh, me tell you to run.
All the way, all the way.
I'm over to see, I'm over to y'all. Well, I would like to hold my little hand. How we will run with, how we will cry.